Now, to talk about Vietnamese beliefs and culture means discussing religion. Dr. Hinton has used the term religious spiritual complex to describe the relationship between religiosity and the Vietnamese perspective on dementia and caregiving. The major religious beliefs that dominate among Vietnamese are Confucianism and Taoism, Buddhism and Christianity. And in the periphery is folk religion, which was actually practiced in Vietnam before the other religions and continues to be intertwined with them. It's a set of deeply ingrained practices that prominently features the world of spirits and emphasizes reverence for our ancestors, as well as the belief that all life and objects have spirits. You'll see this practiced in Vietnamese homes and businesses through the burning of incense in front of pictures of deceased relatives, usually a parent or a grandparent or other first-line relatives. For the most part, the theme of paying homage to ancestors will be present, whether your Vietnamese clients are professed Buddhists, Catholic, or one of the other Christian denominations. Confucianism and Taoism are two philosophies that have deeply influenced Vietnamese culture. Their teachings are so strongly ingrained that they almost represent a way of living, and I can safely say that almost all accepted Vietnamese practices regarding important undertakings involving relationships, commerce, government, or the practice of religion can be found to have roots within Confucian thought. Within your practice as clinicians, you'll especially see this played out in the importance with which most Vietnamese view hierarchy and relationships. This hierarchy is the structure for the so-called cardinal relationships, which refer to the relationship between husband and wife, parent and offspring, teacher and student, and less relevant to our topic today, government and people. The importance of these relationships underscores the Confucian mandate of filial piety and practice of ancestor worship, both of which Vietnamese are taught to practice in relation to self-cultivation and the living of a life that is good through moral action and behavior. Many Taoist practices regarding universal harmony are the foundations for Vietnamese beliefs regarding health and living. The Vietnamese emphasis on quote unquote hot and cold elements, better known in the West as yin and yang, and the widespread use of homeopathic remedies and herbs for general health purposes are rooted in Taoism. So, one of the bits of information that you would need to integrate into your routine assessments when working with Vietnamese, for instance, is whether they're using medicinal herbs. You may not come across this often, but Taoism has a mystic side to it as well that believes in communing with the spirits of ancestors. Vietnamese practices such as having one's fortune read, especially by Taoist priests at Lunar New Year, seeking guidance from spirits through mediums and using Taoism as a means of bridging the world of humans and the supernatural are very much part of the culture. And it is in this context that your patient may tell you of their experiences trying to cure various ailments and symptoms through the use of temple priests and shamans. Most of us are familiar with the Buddhist precept that suffering is inevitable. In addition to that, the Mahayana school of Buddhist thought, which is the one prevalent in Vietnam, also emphasizes engaging with the world at large with benevolence, compassionate thought, and the practice of goodwill toward others. Along with that teaching is that the person you are in action, word, and thought creates your dharma. And if you haven't learned to be a good person in this life, you'll be reborn to spend another lifetime suffering and trying to rectify your past actions. Although Christian values are more connected than disconnected with Buddhism, it is fundamentally different in philosophy and a major departure. Because while Buddhism advocates all the wonderful practices of compassion, charity, and the like, it is to avoid being reborn. But Christianity teaches us to seek forgiveness for our sins through prayer, to be charitable of spirit and action in order to be reborn to a glorious afterlife. I hope that what you're getting from my simplistic rendering of these very important religions is that for the typical Vietnamese, what is held in esteem is the character and moral fiber of an individual, as demonstrated through the way she treats her neighbor or her teacher, mother, or the demented aunt for that matter. Because with the exception of ancestral worship, the other major religious and cultural influences are all about interpersonal relationships, how to conduct yourself within those relationships, and living a moral life. Which brings us to how the religious spiritual complex is the foundation for Vietnamese culture and influential among Vietnamese caregivers. From the three primary religions, we can point to the Confucian teaching of filial piety as a strong motivator. This is also true of Christianity and Buddhism, both of which admonish followers to honor our mother and father. And applied within the Vietnamese culture, the teaching is evidenced in honoring and caring for the older generation. You'll find that even the language reflects this reverence, with the use of titles and respect assigned according to age. Traditional and predominant expectations are that there is a duty and reciprocity, that when the older generation becomes sick, the younger folks are supposed to, quote unquote, give back and take care of them in their old age. I kind of think of what Yoda said to the Jedi, do or do not, there is no try, and you'll get the idea. Along with the importance of taking care of one's elders, because the religions teach that it is a moral and necessary thing to do, charity, compassion, and grace are also driving factors that we find help caregivers cope. Caregivers also cite improving their karma by doing good deeds as a motivation. This was true in the traditional Buddhist sense of rectifying the wrong done in a previous life to avoid reincarnation through good work. But it was also mixed into the belief system of those caregivers who were devoutly Catholic. And another factor I need to talk about that is on the previous slide is the belief in fate and acceptance of one's fate in life. This is related to the teaching that suffering is inevitable. The caregiver believes he or she is dealt a certain hand in life or was meant to repeat his life in order to right a past wrong. And so must accept what comes, be it miserable or joyous. Okay, getting back to the slide. Vietnam is rife with beliefs involving the spiritual religious complex for explaining why life can be so hard, and it is equally so when Vietnamese caregivers have been interviewed about how their care recipient's dementia came about. Keep in mind that even if your patient or his family continues to talk about illness within the perspective of their cultural context, it doesn't mean that they won't integrate what you'll tell them of the commonly believed causes of dementia. Among Vietnamese, it will be more likely that everything you tell them will become interwoven with the beliefs they already hold. A common Vietnamese attribute for illness is the belief that symptoms of illnesses are due to a biological or physical imbalance caused by eating the wrong kind of foods or doing the wrong things. Similarly, the caregiver you're receiving history from, or the patient himself, may believe that he is now experiencing forgetfulness and having short-term memory problems because of family strife or stress experienced during the war and migration years. Lastly, there is a belief among some Vietnamese that dementia is caused by spiritual possession. This idea is naturally very fascinating to most people not familiar with the practices of the more mystical sects of the religion, but it's easy to see how some caregivers may attribute problematic behaviors such as wandering out into the street at night or the violent and socially inappropriate behaviors of a person with Lewy body dementia, for instance, with the supernatural world. Dr. Hinton developed this very nifty diagram here, which shows and underscores how Vietnamese religious and cultural beliefs about illness and societal mores are all interrelated. As you can see, the major religions and their precepts and the experiences that caregivers have cited in relation to their beliefs.